Hello and welcome to another episode of today's GK. I am Pooja Dwivedi, and in this segment we bring to you object questions on a daily basis to help you crack prelims. So let's begin with the practice question of last segment, which says, consider the following statements with reference to development finance institutions. These institutions provide risk capital for economic development projects, mainly on non-commercial basis. During the pre-liberalized era, India had DFIs that were primarily engaged in development of industry in the country. And in India, the first DFI was operationalized before independence with the setting up of the Industrial Finance Corporation. Moving on to the statements amongst which you have to choose, which of the statements given above is or are correct? 2 only, 1 and 2 only, 3 only, 1, 2 and 3. So the correct answer for this question is B, that is 1 and 2 only, the first and the second statements. These two statements are correct. Moving on to the explanation. The government's latest budget proposes to set up a development finance institution soon to fund the ambitious national infrastructure pipeline. If we talk about national infrastructure pipeline, this project is introduced in order to enhance employment and also ease of living. That means it will create jobs in the energy, infrastructure, railway sector in order to provide jobs to millions of people who have found themselves out of job during the entire COVID-19 induced lockdown. So if we talk about from which fiscal year to which fiscal year it is valid, you have to tell me in the comment segment that. Alright? Moving on, a development finance institution, also known as the development bank, it is a financial institution that provides risk capital for economic development projects on non-commercial basis. It could be a distorted statement that it provides risk capital for commercial basis, on commercial basis. But no, it provides it on non-commercial basis. Moving on, during the pre-liberalized era, India had DFIs which were primarily engaged in development of industry in the country, and in India, the first DFI ever was operationalized in the year 1948 with the setting up of the Industrial Finance Corporation. Moving on, subsequently, the Industrial Credit and Investment Corporation of India was set up with the help of the backing of World Bank in the year 1955, and the IDBI came into existence in 1964 to promote long-term financing for infrastructure projects and industry. Moving on to the next question, which of the following amounts to the defeat of the government? Failure to pass motion of thanks, rejection of a money bill, passing a censure motion or an adjournment motion, passing of private member bills. So, if we talk about which of the following bills which are given here, if they are voted against, they are not passed, it will lead to the defeat of the government. That means the government will no hold a legitimate power to work as the government of our democracy. Alright, so select the correct code. 1, 2 and 3 only, 2, 3 and 4 only, 1, 3 and 4 only, 1, 2, 3 and 4. The correct answer to this question is A, that is 1, 2 and 3 only. Moving on to the explanation, the motion of thanks must be passed in the House, otherwise it amounts to the defeat of the government, and it is one of the ways through which the Lok Sabha can also express a lack of confidence in the government. That means if they do not pass these particular bills, these particular motions, the parliament, because the executive is ultimately answerable and accountable to the legislature, and legislature body that we have in our country is the parliament. So the parliament has a way of showing that they do not trust the government now, and they do not have faith in the government now through the non-passing of such bills. Alright, and the other ways are rejection of a money bill, passing a censure motion or an adjournment motion, also the defeat of the government on any vital issue and passing a cut motion, and passing of private member bills do not amount to the defeat of the government. Who is a private member? A private member is a member of the parliament that does not work on the behalf of the executive. That means he or she is not a minister. Alright, moving on, let's talk about next question. Article 340, often seen in the news, deals with finance commission, linguistic officer, interstate trade, backward classes. So the correct answer for this question is D, that is backward classes. Moving on to the explanation. Article 340 deals with the appointment of a commission to investigate the conditions of backward classes. The president may by order appoint a commission consisting of such persons as he thinks fit to investigate the conditions of socially and educationally backward classes within the territory of India. Moving on to the next question, the Mandarin duck, which is a colorful duck, was spotted in India recently after 118 years is in Karnataka, Rajasthan, Andaman and Nicobar and Assam. So this is a very logical answer if you are able to reach through it, that Mandarin is Chinese. Which state has its closest border with China? It's Assam, lies very close to China. So that means the correct answer to this question is Assam. Alright, moving on. The Mandarin duck, which is a colorful duck from Eastern Asia, was spotted in Assam recently after 118 years. It was spotted from Maguri Mutapung Bill of Tinsukia district in Eastern Assam. Moving on to the next question, which of the following missions are related to Mars? Hope mission, Insight mission, Magellan mission, Perseverance mission. So you have to select the correct code, 1, 2 and 3 only, 2, 3 and 4 only, 1, 2 and 4 only, 1, 2, 3 and 4. The correct answer to this question is C, that is 1, 2 and 4 only. Moving on to the explanation. The Magellan mission was launched by NASA to Venus and not to Mars. It was the first spacecraft to image the entire surface of Venus and made several discoveries about the planet and rest our missions to Mars. Hope mission has been a mission by UAE. It will investigate how dust, storms and other weather phenomena near the Martian surface speed or slow the loss of planet's atmosphere into space. InSight and Perseverance mission by NASA, if we talk about that, InSight mission aims to look deep beneath the Martian surface and Perseverance mission will seek signs of ancient life and collect rock and soil samples from Mars. Moving on to the next question, Chopra Committee, recently seen in the news, is related to non-performing assets, Interstate Trade and Commerce, GST Council, Hydroelectric Power Projects. The correct answer to this question is D, that is Hydroelectric Power Projects. So the Chopra Committee studied the impacts of receding glaciers on hydroelectric power projects and objected to the constructions of HEPs and paraglacial regions between 2200 to 2500 meters above the sea level. So if we talk about the glaciers are in tatters because of the rise in the global climate, global temperature, climate change, and of course receding precipitation. Because of that, the supply of water, the supply of rivers are of course the glaciers, and because of that the power is supposed to be harnessed through these rivers, and the rivers are not in that much of potentiality to provide that much power, and that is why it is causing a negative impact on HEPs. Alright, moving on, let's talk about our next question. Consider the following sentences about Bharat stage norms based on the American regulations introduced in the year 2000. The Bharat stage norms are emission control standards put in place to keep a check on air pollution, and these standards set specifications and limits for the release of air pollutants from equipments using internal combustion engines, including vehicles. The higher the stage, the more stringent would become the norms. BS6 norms seek to cut down sulfur content to zero. Which of the above sentences is or are correct? 1, 2 and 3 only. 2 and 3 only, 1, 2 and 4 only, 1, 2, 3 and 4. The correct answer to this question is B, that is 2 and 3 only. The second and the third statements are correct. Moving on to the explanation. If we talk about Bharat stage norms, these are based on the European regulations or Euro norms introduced in the year 2000. The Bharat stage norms are emission control standards put in place by the government to keep a check on air pollution. These standards set specifications and limits for the release of air pollutants from equipment using internal combustion engines, including vehicles as well. And the higher the stage, the more stringent the norms. If we talk about BS6 norms, seek to cut down sulfur content. Just remember that. It could be asked in your preliminary exam statement that it seeks to cut down ozone or nitrogen. But here we have to remember it's sulfur. Alright, to 10 parts per million from 50 parts per million. And sulfur is the in the fuel contributes to fine particulate matter emissions. Also, BS6 norms seek to reduce the level of certain harmful hydrocarbons in the emissions that are produced due to incomplete combustion of fuel. Moving on to the next question, very important. With reference to Union Public Service Commission, consider the following statements. The conditions of service of the chairman or a member are determined by the president. And the chairman and members of the commission hold office for a term of 6 years or until they attain the age of 65 years, whichever is earlier. Moving on to the statements, you have to choose from one only, two only, both one and two. Neither one nor two. The correct answer to this question is, of course, C. That is both one and two. So, the conditions of service of the chairman or a member are determined by the president, and the chairman and members of the commission hold office for a term of 6 years or until they attain the age of 65 years, whichever is earlier. Alright, many a times it happens, we are studying for UPSC, but the questions related to UPSC comes and then we falter. Remember the correct statements with reference to UPSC, alright. Moving on, Union Public Service Commission is the central recruiting agency in India and is an independent constitutional body in the sense that it has been directly created by the constitution. That means it draws its powers from the constitution of India, and the chairman as well as members of the commission hold office for a term of 6 years or until they attain the age of 65 years, whichever is earlier. However, they can relinquish their offices at any time by addressing their resignation to the president, and the conditions of service of the chairman or a member, though determined by the president, cannot be varied to his or her disadvantage after his or her appointment. All right. Trump's Shakti portal, often seen in the news, is under the aegis of Ministry of Tribal Affairs, Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Ministry of Education, and Ministry of Ayush. The correct answer to this question is A, that is Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Moving on to the explanation. Now, recently, the Ministry of Tribal Affairs has launched Shram Shakti, a national migration support portal to smooth the formulation of state and national level programs for migrant workers. A training manual, Shram Sathi, was also launched for migrant workers. And if we talk about this portal, it has been launched to collect data related to tribal migrant workers and link them with the existing, that means already in work, welfare schemes. It will help in empowering the workers who generally migrate in search of employment and income generation as well. Moving on to the next question, consider the following statements. Seaweeds are the primitive, non-flowering marine algae without root, stem and leaves, and seaweeds found mostly in the intertidal region in shallow and deep waters of the sea but not in estuaries and backwaters. Which of the statements given above is or are correct? One only, two only, both one and two, neither one nor two. The correct answer to this question is A, that is one only. So seaweeds, recently the Technology Information Forecasting and Assessment Council, that is the TIFAC, has launched the seaweed mission, and they are primitive marine non-flowering marine algae without root, stem and leaves. They play a major role in marine ecosystems, and large seaweeds from dense underwater forests known as kelp forests, which act as an underwater nurseries for fish, snails and sea urchins. Some species of seaweeds, that is Gelidella, Acerosa, Gracilaria, Edulis, Gracilaria, Crassa, Gracilaria, Verrucosa and Sargassum, SWP and Turbinaria, SWP seaweeds found mostly in the intertidal region, in shallow and deep waters of the sea and also in estuaries and backwaters. Moving on to the next question, which of the following statements is or are correct about Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme, that is MNREGS? At least one third of beneficiaries have to be women. This is the first, and it was launched in the year 2004. You have to select the answer using the codes given below. One only, two only, both one and two, neither one nor two. The correct answer to this question is A, that is one only. Alright, moving on. It is one of the largest work guarantee programs in the world, and it was launched on 2nd February 2006. The MNREGS Act was passed on 23rd August 2005, and the objective of the scheme is to guarantee 100 days of employment in every financial year to adult members of any rural household willing to do public work related unskilled manual work. And if we talk about the legal right to work, unlike earlier employment guarantee schemes the Act aims at addressing, the causes of chronic poverty through a rights-based framework, and at least one-third of the beneficiary have to be women, and wages must be paid in accordance to the statutory minimum wages specified for agricultural laborers in the state under the Minimum Wages Act of 1948. Moving on to the practice question, with reference to Rights of Persons with Disabilities Act 2016, you have to consider the following statements. It increased the quantum of reservation for people suffering from disabilities from 3% to 4% in government jobs and 3 to 5% in higher education institutes, and benchmark disability refers to having at least 50% disability of any type recognized under this act. Alright? Also, let's choose which of the statements given above is or are correct. 1 only, 2 only, both 1 and 2, neither 1 nor 2. I hope you will be able to answer this question correctly in the comments segment. That's it for today. Tomorrow we shall meet again with another segment. Until then, stay updated and thank you so much for watching.